Welcome back. It's a phrase no one wants to hear, let alone a young woman. You have cancer. As your life flashes in front of you and you begin the battle of your life, you then learn the treatments that could save you could also take away the possibility of having children. But thankfully, there are now options, and we are joined today by Dr. Hallie Moore, an oncologist from the Cleveland Clinic, and Aaron McGinty, a beautiful 31-year-old cancer patient who recently made a decision about how to preserve her fertility. Thank you both for being here. Let's start with you, Dr. Moore, because chemotherapy has been the standard treatment, and a lot of women, especially at 31 years old, not wanting to hear news like this, that's what they think they have to deal with, but there's a new treatment out there. Kind of tell us a little bit about that.
Right, so there, unfortunately, well, chemotherapy has done a lot to improve the outcomes for women with early stage breast cancer. It also is associated with some long-term side effects, one of which is putting women into early ovarian failure. Right. And that, of course, can reduce the prospects for having children in the future. So there are a number of more traditional options with collecting ovaries or collecting eggs from, from the ovaries to either fertilize those and store embryos or to just freeze the eggs themselves. Those processes do take some time and also are fairly costly. Not everybody has a partner available to make an embryo. So there's some issues about the more standard reproductive technology right. options. What we have looked at is whether suppressing ovarian function with medications during chemotherapy, basically to put a woman into a temporary menopause during the treatment, can prevent long-term menopause. And we found from our studies that indeed we had about a 70% reduction in the risk of developing ovarian failure.
And so how long have you been using this new treatment?
So we've been studying this for more than a decade now. Mm-hmm. For the past several years, we've had pretty strong evidence that this was a successful approach. Wow. So we've been doing this routinely for several years now.
That's amazing. Erin, I want to talk to you. Tell us a little bit about your diagnosis.
Sure. I was diagnosed with breast cancer back in February.
Okay.
Prior to that, I was a healthy, fit, active young woman. No signs, no family history. So I felt a lump. I went to my doctor, had a mammogram, had a needle core biopsy. Everything escalated really quickly. I found out the next day that I had cancer. So to say it was a shock is an understatement.
Yeah.
And devastating news.
You're in a lot of pain. What do you do for the pain?
During chemo, that's when I had a lot of pain. They give you a lot of pain medication, which is great, but
You had a 10-hour surgery.
Yeah, I had a double mastectomy in July, and I had a 10-hour surgery. It was awful. It was extremely, extremely painful.
So how did you get through this?
Honestly, the support of my fiancé, Kevin, my family, my friends, my coworkers, my work family. It's an overwhelming diagnosis to have, especially at a young age, but also the love. And the support was so overwhelming in such a good way. You know, that's what lifted me up on the bad days.
Dr. Moore, fertility counseling has also been a new standard.
Right, so we have a program at the Cleveland Clinic where anybody who's actually under the age of 50, so the young, as we get older, what's considered young gets
right.
a little bit.
Right.
We automatically refer these individuals for fertility counseling along with genetic counseling and along with our typical multidisciplinary consultations with radiation oncology, surgery.
And you can attest to that helped you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And of course, family and friends.
Absolutely.
They've raised a lot of money for you.
Yes. It was amazing.
Yeah.
I would just cry every day looking at the GoFundMe. Just simply amazing.
So you and your fiance have talked about having kids, and this
Correct.
Is why you went this route.
Yes. So we had just gotten engaged.
Yeah.
We have a 6-year-old, but we definitely wanted to expand our family and have more kids. We're supposed to get married in August. We ended up postponing that. It was just too much.
Yeah.
But I was really thankful through the clinic, they got me in touch with a fertility doctor. And honestly, I didn't even know my options. I didn't know anything. So going through each option, really getting educated on the process and just ultimately deciding what the best choice was for me. It was a choice that you had to make very quickly before chemotherapy started. Sure. So it was very stressful. We did a lot of research, and I ended up choosing a hormone injection that I was given once a month during chemotherapy to preserve my ovaries.
And doctor, how long will she have to wait to conceive then?
Well, the standard recommendation is to wait about 2 years at least after treatment, just to make sure you're past that very high risk time period.
And beginning. What is the difference between these treatments with the chemotherapy and the new one? And what is the name of this new treatment called again?
So there's a class of drugs called GnRH analogs. And there's a couple of different ones. There's leuprolide, like what Erin received. There's gazarolin, which is the drug we looked at in the clinical trial. This is given along with the chemotherapy.
Okay.
So it's given basically to suppress the ovaries while she continues to get her standard treatment that we know is going to help improve her outcome.
Well, what a blessing that is with the new treatment, the new information, what you guys are doing at the Cleveland Clinic. We appreciate you sharing and sharing your story as
well. Thank you so much.
You're getting married in June?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I said, are you excited? Are you stressed? And you're like, actually, this is taken away from what
you're
having to go
through. Very happy distraction.
Yeah,
right.
So that's wonderful. So congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So we're praying for you. Thanks,
thank
doctor.
Thank you.
Appreciate you coming in. Your time now, 8:44 this morning. We'll, of course, talk about new forms of radiation that can protect the heart as well, and that's all coming up as well.